Hello again. I'm Dr. Deb, and I am the Learning Strategies Department Chair and Instructor here at VC. In today's video, I'm following up the How to Improve Your Information Processing video with a video detailing how to use retrieval practice most effectively. VC's Total Learning Center presents Dr. Deb Explains Retrieval Practice. In my last video, I mentioned how retrieving information from long-term memory helps build the connections that are needed in order to keep the information accessible to you over time. This happens because the more you use the neural connections, the stronger they get. But what is the best way to retrieve that information? There are many methods that you can use in order to practice retrieval. You can use flashcards, as long as you do it correctly. You can make practice quizzes, or simply think about or list information without looking. Basically, any time that you try to recall the information without looking is using retrieval practice. But how many times do you need to recall it to ensure that you have it available on exam day? The answer to that question isn't as clear cut. Ideally, the more you actively use and apply the information, the better it will be for you. But you have to understand it and know it and not just memorize it. So the more meaning you can put behind it, the better it will be. And the more connections you make with it, the better it will be. This is because you will have the information connected in many more places in your long-term memory, so you will be able to recall it from a variety of places as well. The ideal method is to recall it as soon as possible after it's introduced. This could be as you drive home after class, after reading about it in a textbook, or after watching it in a video. Then review. Don't just read, interact with the material, and recall it again the next day. And if possible, review and recall the information again on the third day before the next class session begins. Then you will learn new material and have that information to recall just as you did the day one material, which is 3 days of recall. However, you don't want to forget the first material. But you don't need to recall that material as actively now. Occasionally, as you review day two material, recall an item from day one as well. Some research indicates that being able to recall an item successfully for 3 tries means that you can drop it from the active daily recall process. At this point, you'll want to review the information about once a week in order to keep the information handy and see if you still know it. If you do, great. Drop it from the recall rotation until the next week. If you don't, add it to the daily recall list again until you can successfully recall it 3 days in a row. I would suggest keeping an ongoing list of key points and terms to remember. As you obtain new material, add it to the list. Then each day, take the topic, state what you know about it. If you are successful, put a tick mark beside it. If you aren't, leave it blank. Review that information and try it again the next day. Once you have 3 tick marks beside a topic, only review that information weekly. That is how retrieval practice helps ensure information processing occurs. Leave a comment below and tell me what you think about this method of studying. Do you think it will work for you? If you want to know more about how to be a successful college student based on theories, strategies, and principles for student success, click the subscribe button and hit the notification bell, and check out my other videos as Dr. Deb Explains.